my friends, for today's beer review, we're going to be taking a look at Ommegang Brewery's Abbey Ale, a Belgian double.
So this is Abbey Ale by Ommegang Brewery, which is basically kind of a play on words from real Abbey Ales from the abbeys over in Belgium and the like, where they have the monasteries who brew beer. And so this is, I guess, kind of Ommegang Brewery's take on that style. And this says, Abbey Ale Double Ale, an ale brewed with licorice root, star anise, sweet orange peel, coriander, and it says cumin, that's weird, rich, fruity, and aromatic burgundy brew. That sounds pretty interesting. It comes in at 8.2% ABV, so it's decently on the high side, but you'll definitely feel it after you drink this entire big bottle, which I do intend to do. Has some interesting wording about the brewery on the left side, but I've read that before. But on the right side, it talks about the brew itself, and it says, Ommegang Abbey Ale is directly influenced by the patience and wisdom of the Benedictines who ever seek divine union, a pretty high standard for an ale, but a good one, we think. Deep burgundy color, rich and malty. Enjoy with savory dishes, rich cheeses, and almost every dessert. Part of the Dubbel family of fine Belgian ales. Pour slowly so as not to disturb the yeast sediment, but with enough vigor to create a luxurious head and release the rich bouquet. We'll see about that. So, there's not much more to say about this. I will say that I hope this changes my mind about the style. I'm not a huge fan of doubles. I like triples and quads and dark Belgian styles. Not a big fan of golden Belgian ales. Duvel is pretty nice, but I'm just not a big fan of them. And the doubles, so far, what I've had, I haven't had many, but from what I've had, they haven't really impressed me. But I have a feeling if anyone can do it, it's Ommegang. So I'm going to be drinking this out of a Belgian beer chalice, as they like to call it. So let's get the cage and the cork off of here. I have this thing just barely chilled, because you're supposed to serve these types of beer at what do they call, cellar temperature, which is like 55 to 58 degrees. So it may even be warmer than that, but it's probably right where it needs to be. Okay, the cage is off. Oh, wow. It was ready to come out. I'm going to get this into the bottle right now. So it is, looks like orange apple juice almost. Very orange amber color. I'm glad I did that, you know, after I pulled the cork out and the bottle didn't just explode, huh? I'm going to have to take points off for that, I think. So, you know, all in all, it could have gone a lot worse. It didn't spill anywhere and there's no cracks or anything in the bottle. So, once again, as I said, pouring it out of the bottle, the color is kind of like a very deep orange rust and amber color, which looks nice. Easily enough there for probably another glass to a glass and a half even. Yeah, a couple of little drips got on the glass here, but that's okay. Up in the light, it is a ridiculously dark, kind of bloody mahogany ruby sort of color. Formed about a finger of lightly tan, very frothy, soapy head. The bubbles in it are huge and popping quickly, so it probably won't stick around for very long. So let's go ahead and give it a smell. Not a super complex smell on it. It has a lot of yeast and malt. There's definitely some of those just Belgian characteristics that you get from these beers of dark fruits, where it's got like little touches of black cherry, perhaps a small touch of wine, and a little bit of alcohol in it too, but what really just shines through is the strong malt character, the yeast character. It almost smells like if you've ever smelled an ancient ale or an old ale, kind of like Founder's Curmudgeon, where it's just heavy on the malt. That's what it smells like. So without further ado, let's give it a taste. I like that. It's got lots of sweet, almost champagne sort of characteristics up front. Lots of good amount of carbonation, like you would expect from a Belgian. You might get very light, fine touches of wine and a really strong amount of a malty bitterness in the end of the development. I really like it. It's actually quite sessionable. And on the exhale, sometimes you get things on the exhale of a beer. This has got like black cherry and marzipan. Maybe even a little bit of almond, which is really interesting. And for being such a big beer, this is actually very drinkable. I would call it sessionable, honestly, for what it is and how it tastes and how it drinks. It's not too overly rich. It still has a thirst-quenching, satisfying, crisp and clean property to it. But it's got enough of that warming, winish kind of kick and taste to let you know it is a Belgian ale. Most impressively at all is how balanced it is. A lot of the doubles are extremely over the top sweet, from what I've noticed. This one is not. This one is very balanced between the sweetness, the savory, and the bitter. Really good. I think that for being in an American brewery, they did a good job at kind of coming into their own on that classic Belgian double style that they're trying to get with this. So, if you're a fan of doubles specifically, or a fan of the Belgian style, really, in general, you'll probably enjoy Ommegang's Abbey Ale. So, that has been my review of it. As far as a score goes, I'm going to give it an 8.9. It's really good. It almost pushes an A. There are definitely, though, a couple of Belgian-styled beers. For a double, I'd probably give it so far from what I've had, a 9. But just comparing it to just Belgian's beer styles, kind of like, triples and quads and the like in general, what I would prefer, it'd be like an 8.9. And just as a beer, it's an 8.9. But that's just my opinion. Anyway, that has been Ommegang Brewery's Abbey Ale. Hope you guys enjoyed the review as always, and stay tuned for the next one.